let us sing praises. Come, let us love God. Come, let us bless His name. God is a stronghold. God is a safety. So let us bless His name. Come, let us praise the Lord. Thank Him with all His song. Come, let us meet the Lord. Praise Him with all His song. Our God is great, above other God. He is the King of heaven and earth. Come, let us sing praises. Come, let us love God. Come, let us bless His name. God is a stronghold. God is a safety. So let us bless His name.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. During this celebration, let us pray for all these below intentions. From the Nendrakal Parish, Kamagudem, this Mass is offered by Divyavani TV Corpus Fund Donor, Madhanu Innaya, for good health of Madhanu Innaya, Jayashila, Mary, Rosalina, Francis Joseph, Madhanu Augustine, thanking God for all the graces received for the departed souls of Madhanu Chinnaya, Arogyamma, Madhanu Mary Margaret, B. Ratnamma, B. Joseph, Paul, Maria Razu, and today's Rosary, Divine Mercy Chaplet, Word of God, Holy Hour are also offered for this family and their intentions. This Mass is offered for special intention for all the parishioners who are affected by COVID-19 virus of St. John of Arc Church, Rajahmundry Parish. May the good Lord protect and keep them safe and healthy through the intercession of Blessed Virgin Mary and St. Joseph, the protector of the family, offered by Mrs. Rina Rolfi. From the Archdiocese of Vishakhapatnam Diocese, Sitamadhara Parish, this Mass is offered for the occasion of Mother's Day. May the Lord Jesus Christ shower His blessings on Teresa, Elizabeth and Swarnalata and grant them good health, offered by Francis, Ogayasi and family members. From the Archdiocese of Vishakhapatnam, Sitamadhara Parish, Thanksgiving Mass for solving a problem that occurred at the workplace, offered by Teresa, Ogayasi and all the family members. From the parish of Kakinada, this Mass is offered for Tim Martin and Zuni on their wedding anniversary for good health and good future by Pranoy, Petrina, Hemant and family members. From the Mutlur Parish, this Mass is offered for good health of Father Eruva Joji Reddy by Tumma Sudhakar Reddy, Sandhya and family members. This Mass is offered to the Sacred Heart of Jesus for a special intention by Arul Ross and family members. This Mass is also offered for the soul of Genevieve Warren on her death anniversary, for the soul of Cartland Warren, and Thanksgiving Mass to Sacred Heart of Jesus for the good health of our family by Olaf and Sylvia Mendoza. From the Archdiocese of Hyderabad, this Mass is offered for the Mother's Day for good health of Bhagyamma, Leela, Mariamma, Lourdamma, Silvamma by R. Arpita and their family members. Keeping all these intentions in our minds, let us also bring all our special intentions, family and personal intentions, and offer them to the altar of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, at the outset of this Holy Eucharistic celebration, I wish all the mothers happy Mother's Day. And we know, we experience God through our mothers. We experience God's love through our mother's love. So that is the speciality of mother in every individual life. It means that God still continues to love every individual through the love shown by our mothers. So as we partake in this Holy Eucharistic celebration, let us spend some time whether we are faithful to our mothers. And secondly, and today's liturgy of the word from the first reading taken from the Acts of the Apostles helps us that God extends his love towards the universal church, towards the universe, that everyone is worthy of God's calling. Everyone is worthy of God being loved by the Lord. And the second reading taken from the first letter of St. John, we understand that Jesus Christ is the embodiment of God's love. And the third reading taken from the Gospel according to St. John chapter 15 verses 9 to 17, we understand also that you love because you are loved by God. That's why we need to love each other. So Jesus says we are chosen by the Lord to be with him, to extend the love what we personally experience. So as we partake in this Holy Eucharistic celebration, let us remember the incidents. Let us also remember the situations where we could not show God's love towards our neighbor, where we could not show God's love towards the needy, and ask God's pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fall, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison. Glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of good will. Glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy, your name. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. God in the highest and on earth,
peace to people of goodwill. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest and on earth. Peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. Grant Almighty God that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we revive in remembrance, we may always hold to it in what we do, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostle, chapter 10, verse 25, 26, and 34, 35, and 44 to 48. Chapter 10, verse 25, 26, 34 and 35, and 44 to 48. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him and fell down at his feet and worshipped him. But Peter lifted him up, saying, "Stand up, I too am a man." And Peter opened his mouth and said, "Truly I perceive that God shows no partiality, but in every nation anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him." While Peter was still saying this, the Holy Spirit fell on all who heard the word, and the believers from among the circumcised who came with Peter were amazed, because the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles. For they heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter declared, "Can anyone forbid water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" And commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Jesus Christ. Then they asked him to remain for some days.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response shall be, "The Lord has shown
the Lord has shown
his salvation to the nations.
His salvation to the nation.
Sing a new song to the Lord, for he has worked wonders. His right hand and his holy arm have brought salvation." Your response, The Lord has shown his salvation to the nations.
His salvation to the nation.
The Lord has made known his salvation, has shown his justice to the nations. He has remembered his truth and love for the house of Israel. Your response: the Lord has shown
His
salvation to the nations.
His salvation to the nation.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout to the Lord, all the earth, ring out your joy. Your response: the Lord has shown
His
salvation to the nations.
His salvation to the nation.
Second reading: a reading from the first letter of Saint John, chapter 4, verse 7 to 10. First letter of Saint John, chapter 4, verse 7 to 10. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and he who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. In this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent His only Son into the world so that we might live through Him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son to be the expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Singing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Let us be glad in it. Let us be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 15, verses from 9 to 17. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no man than this, that a man laid down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends, for all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. This I command you, to love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we are all precious in the sight of God. We are all precious in the sight of God, and especially we are all created for a particular purpose. Every individual is created for a particular mission. That's why we have very important episodes from the Gospel of St. John that we have just read. And especially the verse 16, Gospel according to St. John chapter 15, verse 16. The Lord Jesus Christ lets us know that he says that I have chosen you, you have not chosen me. This is very important verse of today's gospel reading. When he says I have chosen you, which means he called us, it is he who called us to existence. It is he who has created us for his purpose sake, for his mission sake. That's why we are not the creatures of just a small accident. We are all planned. We are all planned by the Lord, and that's why we have existence in the presence of the Lord or in the sight of the Lord. And also, it is not the mere decision of your parents that they wanted to love each other. That's why you are here. That's how you are find your existence here on earth. But my brothers and sisters, we are born and we live for his sake. Since he wills, then we have existence. And especially my brothers and sisters, he continues to say that he has chosen us, that he has called us, he has chiseled us, and he has special mission and purpose for every individual life. That's what we hear from the book of Jeremiah chapter 1 verses 5. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I have chosen you. This is not only the promise of the Lord, but this is the plan of God. And also we hear in book of Isaiah chapter 43 verse 4, he says you are precious. And the same book of Isaiah chapter 49 verse 16, he says I have carved you. Which means, my brothers and sisters, it is God who wants us. You may be unwanted by the people. You are unwanted, you are rejected, you are shunned by the people. But you remember and meditate, memorize that you are wanted by the Lord. In your family, you may be unwanted daughter. You may be unwanted son. Even the parents, you may be unwanted mother and father. But remember, God wants you. You are wanted by the Lord. That's why he has chosen you. That's how you are precious in his sight. That's why God extends, shows his love towards every individual being here on earth. That's what we need to understand and personal, and then have God experience, my brothers and sisters. Here I would like to reflect with you. God has chosen all of us for a particular reason, for a particular person and mission. In the beginning, I want you to meditate that God has chosen all of us to be joyful. He has chosen for joy. So every Christian needs to be very joyful. We read from the letter of St. Paul to Philippians chapter 4 verse 4 that he says, rejoice always. I repeatedly say, rejoice always. My brothers and sisters, William Barclay, a biblical commentator, he says like this, Christian joy is independent of all the things of the earth. Christian joy is independent of all the things of this earth because it has its speciality in the presence of Christ. And the Christian can never lose his joy because he can never lose Christ. William Barclay, Christian commentator, says, we are all freed from the things of this world because Christ is with us. And when Christ is with us, we cannot be in despair. We need to be always in joyful condition. We need to rejoice always. And hence, it is a special calling. God has chosen all of us to be joyful. That's why when we are joyful, when we are with Christ, we have royalty, we have dignity, and we have victory in Jesus. And hence, let us try to be joyful always. Let us try to be rejoiceful in the presence of the Lord. That is because that is the calling of the Lord. And secondly, my brothers and sisters, Jesus, as he promised, he says, I have chosen you to be joyful. And secondly, he has chosen all of us to be his friends. He has chosen us to be his friends. That's what we hear from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 15, verses 14 to 15. He says, you are my friends. No longer I call you servants, because servant does not know what the master is doing. Only the friend to whom God wants to know, let him know, then only he will know the master's mind. He will know the master's thinking. That's why I no longer call you as my servants. I call you friends. So this is a journey. So everyone is invited. Everyone is called to be his disciple. That's why it is a discipleship is a journey from discipleship to servantship, from servantship to friendship. It's a journey, gradual and perpetual journey. Because my brothers and sisters, I would like to elucidate what is discipleship, what is servantship, and what is friendship in the Lord. So disciple is the one who is called by the Lord. So everyone, every Christian is a disciple. But as for Jesus, the one who serves, the one who loves is a servant. So as a disciple, you are given some indications. As a disciple, you are given some directives. As a disciple, you are asked to follow some commandments. If you follow these commandments of the Lord, then you will be called a servant of the Lord. You will be considered as servant for God. When God understands this particular servant of mine, knows my mind, then he will no longer call us as servants. He calls us as friends. Because even when the master's life is demanded at this moment, at very moment, the servant, the friend, he will continue the legacy of the master. The plan of the master is executed by the friend, by the servant who is called by the Lord. And hence, my brothers and sisters, that's why Jesus calls everyone as his friend. When we see the culture of Greeks, they looked at God as revengeful. They looked at God as a jealous God. Even the Jews understood God as El Shaddai, which means all-powerful, almighty, the one who is on the mountain of the Lord. And they had a lot of fear towards the Lord. These are the understanding. Greeks had a great understanding that God was revengeful. Jews had understanding that God was powerful. But Jesus calls here, he builds up new relationship between man and God, that we are in friendship. God calls the man, human being, as his friends. And hence, God is our friend. That's why he has chosen all of us to be his friends. And finally, my brothers and sisters, God has chosen us for love. He expects that we love each other. We extend our love towards our neighbor. Without love, you cannot have faith. Without love, you cannot have God experience. Once there was a priest who lived in island of Hawaii. He had a special calling for the priesthood. He lived priesthood very nicely. But after some time, he had a special call to live in this particular island, Hawaii, where he had to live his rest of life with the lepers. So he goes to this island, Hawaii. There he finds lot of lepers. and he had to live among the lepers and especially leprosarium. Then what does this Father Damien do? He decides to be away from the leprosarium. He creates or he builds a small hut away from these lepers. But every time he stayed away from these lepers, he had a guilty feeling whether he is living up to the calling of the Lord. Small technical problem, sorry. So my dear brothers and sisters, this Father Damien, who was living in the island of Hawaii, he asked the Lord, "Lord, let me know your will, but it is not my will that I'll be among these lepers, among these leprosariums." Then God lets him know, this is the call. If you want to be my servant, if you want to be my friend, if you want to experience my love, you have to by all means live among these huts. You have to by all means live among these lepers. Then he decides to be with them. As he decides, my brothers and sisters, he has a special love of the Lord experienced by himself. He has special experience that he becomes the fingers of the lepers. He becomes the fingers of the lepers. He becomes the hands of the lepers. That's how he lived among them, and he felt at the end of the life, and he died with the leprosy, but he lived a saintly life, my brothers and sisters. In the same manner, God wants us to love one another. This is the special love of the Lord that we need to extend to the world. When we, in this pandemic situation, my brothers and sisters, are you able to love your neighbor? We have frontline warriors working against corona, like nurses, scientists, doctors, municipal staff of municipality, and all the people. Even if you give lakhs of money, we may call them because they are paid, because they are getting some money from the governments, because they are getting some income from the NGOs, they are working. Are you ready to work even if you are paid 1 lakh? There is a beautiful story of the person who always find fault with God. And this particular person was a beggar. He moves on to beg something to eat. Then he finds a beautiful palace. As he approaches the palace, he wanted to get in so that he will get something bigger than the routine. So as he enters this palace, he finds lot of people working for this king. As he approaches later towards the king, then he goes to him and asks for the alms. As he was giving, the king was giving alms to this particular beggar, then this beggar made a statement: "You are blessed so much by the Lord, but I am not blessed. You are so fortunate, but I am so unfortunate," he says. Then the king lets him know that he was blind. Then he asks him, "I will give all my property to you. I will sign and give you all my property, but will you give your eyes to me so that I can work, I can create these properties again?" Then the beggar shuts his mouth off and goes off. My brothers and sisters, this is the situation, pandemic situation. Even if you are given lakhs of money, I think you and me are not ready to work for the Lord. We are not ready to show our love towards the other human beings. Hence, we need to continue to show the love that we experience in our individual lives. Otherwise, we have no existence in this world. So if you want to reach, or if you want to have heavenly bliss of the Lord in heaven, you need to see God here on earth among the poor. You need to see God in your neighbor. If you are able to see God in your neighbor among the poor people, then you be certain, be sure you are made worthy to see or to have the vision of the Lord in the heaven. So let us ask the Lord to bless us with this special gift of love, with the gift of joy, and then we are made worthy to be His friends forever. Dear brothers and sisters, let us all stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the Scriptures, He ascended to heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With the conversion of Cornelius, a prominent official of the Roman army, the doors are open for the Gentiles to become part of the people of God. That the Gentiles accept the offer with joy and gratitude is an indication that they have been longing for this prized procession, that the mission of Jesus may be carried forward. We pray. Your response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy and the religious, that as leaders in the Church, they may carry forward the work of evangelization, that they may be assisted by the Holy Spirit in the exercise of their pastoral ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the distinguishing mark of a Christian may be His ability to love irrespective of religious affiliation and nationality. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The children may learn to respect their parents, teachers and elders, which is an essential quality of the process of growing up. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our families may become places where love reigns, parents loving their children, children showing love and affection for their parents, and parents showing mutual love and respect for each other. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, watching this celebration of Eucharist through Divyavani TV, that the celebration of the last Sunday of Easter may deepen our commitment to Christ and His gospel, which can be summarized as love of God and neighbor. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us bring forward all of our personal and community needs before the altar of God. Let us pray. God our Father, we thank You for the gift of fellowship with Your Son Jesus. After the first outpouring of the Holy Spirit on Jewish believers, that the first Pentecost, You poured it anew and the Gentiles as well. Give us the grace that anointed by the Holy Spirit, we may become bearers of good news. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, make us ready now to share
this meal. Sign of our life in you. Lord, make us ready now to share this meal. Sign of our life in you. We bring you this brute pain of stain of human toil. This bread, not food of slavery. This bread which brings to man, is meal which man shed in happiness. Lord, give it power to make us free. Lord, make us ready now to share this sign of our love in you. Lord, make us ready now to share this sign of our love.
Pray, my dear brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to the loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and our good of all his holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Sing Hosanna. Sing Hosanna, Hosanna to the Lord. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Sing Hosanna. Sing Hosanna. Hosanna to the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit. You give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to your consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus Christ.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Jesus Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope, Holy Antony our Archbishop, and all the order of bishops, and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and found by his divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us, O Lamb of God. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us, O Lamb of God. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world. Peace, and grant us peace, O Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring me to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen. Prayer of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come into my heart spiritually. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself to you wholly. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Is my will, my one command, that love should dwell among you all. This is my will, that you should love, as I have shown that I love you. No greater love a man can have than that he died to save his friend. You are my friends if you obey what I command that you should do.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, who restored us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go for the Mass is ended. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Mary, my mother, I come as your child. Guide me from sin and keep me from strife. Stand by me always, wherever I be. Give me by hand and give me your time. Mother, my mother, I love you so much. I need you, Mother, I need your love. Give me your help when I am in need. You be my strength when I am so weak. Mary, my Mother, I come as your child. Guide me from sin and keep me from strife. Stand by me always, wherever I be. Give me by hand and give me your time.